Now we freeze, we do freezing, we have frozen material before we use them for further processing or before the consumer use it for cooking. What do we need to do? What do they have to do? Thawing. So we will discuss what is thawing. What are the effects of thawing to food? This is important for a food engineer. To study any process, what do you understand? What do you need to understand is the principle of the process. And you also understand the effects of the process on the food. That's what you need to know. And then also we need to discuss a bit the thawing and tempering techniques. Techniques mean about equipment, the method we do. What is thawing? We transfer the heat from a warmer source, air or water, for example, to our frozen food. The target of thawing is to increase the temperature to above freezing point, above 0 degrees C, above your freezing point. So the food will melted, will be melted, sorry. What is tempering? There's another concept here. Tempering is you increase the temperature of your frozen product not to above zero but to minus five to minus two. In this way, your product is still frozen but not very hard anymore. So you can do further processing easily, for example, slicing. When it's at minus 20 degrees C, it's very hard. You cannot slice it. You have to saw it. But sawing take a lot of time. Take a lot of time and you lose some food. But when you do slicing, you don't lose food. So you do like this, you up here, and you can do slicing with a machine to slice very fast. What are the effects of thawing? In some cases, we have thaw rigor. Means the rigor occur when you do thawing. What is rigor mortis? Rigor mortis is because of the muscle contraction after the death of the animal, right? What trigger the rigor mortis? What factor will trigger the rigor mortis? What contain ATP? When ATP is dropped down below a certain level, the muscle will contract and then we will have rigor mortis. You should review again chapter 4, okay? So, but then why we have rigor when we thaw the food? First, we explain what is this first. Thaw rigor is strong contraction with toughening the meat when the meat is thaw. The reason is you freeze the meat so early before the rigor starts or before the rigor or before the onset of rigor. When the ATP is still present, a certain high level, means that you freeze your meat so fast when it doesn't go into rigor yet, then when you thaw, the rigor will occur. Then you will have thaw rigor. And the effect is the meat become tough. Okay, how do we do to prevent this? If we freeze the meat, and we store the meat under frozen for a long time, then the rigor will occur during frozen storage. Why it takes so long time for the rigor to occur? Because the temperature is very low. So you need long time for the rigor to occur. And when the rigor occur, when your food is frozen, high viscosity, it will not contract. Because the ice will not contract. When the rigor pass and then you thaw, you will have no issue. The issue is you freeze before the rigor and you thaw so early after that, then you have it. But now if you wait for several months, maybe it will pass. It takes a long time to occur because the temperature now is very low. The other way they do is instead of doing fast freezing, they increase the temperature to minus 5 and wait for several hours. When the temperature is moving up, the rigor will occur. But then when the temperature is still minus 5, it's still frozen, right? Still like ice, so means that it will not contract. You wait for several hours for the rigor to occur, to pass, and after that, you do further thawing, then it's also okay. Freezing up the rigor gives no special problem with thaw rigor. Mean when the rigor already occur, already pass, no problem. Good. And now, the effects on microbial growth. This point you need to remember. During thawing, the condition for microbial growth are much better compared to during freezing. When you do freezing, the risk of microbial growth is not so much. But when you do thawing, the risk of microbial growth is high. Why? The question is why? Why? Because now you have liquid drip. And this drip doesn't contain water alone, but also the drip, the liquid contain nutrients, a lot of nutrients for microbes on the outside of the meat to grow. And what else? When you do thawing, the temperature outside of the product is higher and higher. And it takes long time or short time to do thawing normally. Normally, if you use air, for example, it takes a long time for thawing. Higher temperature, longer time compared to freezing, more nutrient. And these three conditions favor microbial growth. The best compromise to do thawing, to do not so slow thawing and not so much grow of microorganism, is to use air at this temperature, gently circulated the air with a fan.